learning outcomes. After starting this module, you would be able to understand the meaning of environment, learn the different components of environment, understand the meaning of environmental scanning, know the different techniques of environmental analysis. Introduction. A business is an outcome of its environment. The functioning and growth of the business is influenced by the environment in several ways. The totality of the conditions, events, and influences that affects the functioning of the business is known as business environment. It is very essential for an organization to understand and appreciate the environment in which it has to operate. There are two categories in which environment forces can be classified: internal environment and external environment. Internal environment refers to the conditions and forces existing within an organization that influences its management. Next is the concept of environment. The environment of business is the set of all the forces and factors which are external to and uncontrollable in nature but affect the functioning and growth of the organizations. These consist of competitors, customers, suppliers, government, and the political, legal, social, cultural, and technological factors, etc. These factors influence an organization directly or indirectly. It is important for an organization to recognize, respect, adapt, manage, monitor, influence, and respond to the environment in which it operates. Next is the features of environment. There are many characteristics that are exhibited by the business environment. These are dynamic. The organizational environment is dynamic and keeps on changing. Organizations are compelled to shift gears and change directions due to changes in government regulations, technology, competitive forces, etc. Second, unpredictable. The changes in environment are not predictable. It is not an easy task to forecast the future changes that may occur in the environment. When an environment changes very fast, uncertainty rises. Third, relative. Environment is a relative concept. It differs from region to region and from country to country. For example, the political conditions of India are different from those of China, or northeastern states have more markets for umbrellas than in Rajasthan. Fourth, composite. The environment of an organization is the totality of all the forces and factors that are external to and greatly influence their functioning and growth. Fifth, challenging. All organizations are influenced by the legal, political, technological, economic, and social systems. Jointly, these components constitute the macro environment of an organization. Next is the components of environment. There are two components of business environment. First, internal environment. Second, external environment. Internal environment includes those forces and factors that are controllable by an organization. An organization can modify these changes to suit the changes in the environment. External environment include those forces and factors that are not controllable by an organization. It includes political and legal factors, socio-cultural factors, economic and financial factors, technological factors, natural factors, global factors, etc. There are two types of external environment. First, micro or operating environment. Second, macro or general environment. Micro environment. Micro environment consists those factors which are close to the business and exerts a direct influence on the capacity to work of an organization. These include customers, competitors, suppliers, market intermediaries, and publics. Macro environment. Macro environment consists those factors that offer opportunities and pose threats to the organizations. In order to remain competitive, organizations must envisage these trends and utilize their resources carefully. It consists of the following components. First, economic environment. Economic environment comprises those economic factors which have an impact on the operations of the business. Some of the main forces and factors that operates in the economic environment are the economic systems, that is capitalist, socialist or mixed economy, the politics of an economy such as fiscal, industrial, monetary, export and import policy, economic infrastructure such as banks, transportation and communication facilities, etc. Strategists have the knowledge about the impact of economic environment on their business. They will have to observe all the economic indicators for various reasons. A reduction in interest rate decreases the cost of capital for the organizations. Reforms in industrial and fiscal policies have led to the development of new businesses such as leasing companies, mutual funds, venture capital funds, etc. Second, social and cultural environment. Social and cultural environment includes those factors which have a considerable influence and are beyond an organization's premises. These include demographic factors such as population, age distribution, literacy levels, income distribution, etc. Social institution and groups, customers, values, attitudes, beliefs, rituals and lifestyles. Lastly, taste and preferences of people. Social and cultural environment is highly important for an organization as its crucial decisions depend upon cultural atmosphere in which the business functions. Third, political environment. Political environment include those factors that affects the formulation and implementation of the strategies adopted by the organizations, such as political system, the policies of the government and attitude towards the business community. Also, the operations of business organizations are adversely affected by the strikes, lockouts and labor disputes, etc. Fourth, legal environment. The legal environment plays a very significant role in business. It provides the framework within which every organization has to work. The important legislations that forms the legal business environment includes Companies Act 2013, the Factories Act 1948, Industrial Disputes Act 1972, Essential Commodities Act 2002, Competition Act 2002. Apart from these, the following also forms the legal business environment. Provisions of the Constitution. The functions of business organizations are also influenced by the provisions of the Constitution, such as principles, duties and rights of the citizen, legislative powers of the state and central government. Next, judicial decisions. The activities of the business are also influenced by the various judgments given by the courts related to trade and industry. Fifth, technological environment. Technological factors includes rate of technological change, new processes and equipment, system of research and developments and approaches to production of goods and services. The designing of the products is affected by the changing technological environments of different countries. Sixth, natural environment. Natural environment consists geographical, ecological and topographical factors that affects the operations of the business. These factors include climate conditions, location of the public, availability of the natural resources, etc. For example, those places are suitable for sugar factories where sugarcane can be grown. It is advantageous to set up manufacturing units near the sources of inputs. Also, the responsibilities of the business sector is increased due to the policies of the government to maintain ecological balance, conservation of natural resources, etc. Seventh, international environment. International environment is essential for those industries that depend on export or imports. A slowdown in foreign market may create problems for the exporters. Import liberalization may assist some industries, but may be unfavorable for other countries. For example, the market share of domestic business firms like Videocon is adversely affected due to the coming of multinationals such as LG in the electronic industry. Also, due to certain developments such as hike in crude oil price, many industries such as cement industry, fertilizer industry and automobile industry, etc. has seriously affected. the business is also affected by the various international political factors such as war, political tension, etc. For example, the trade between India and Pakistan has increased due to improvements in relations between these two countries. Next is environmental scanning. Environmental scanning is a systematic process through which organizations monitor and understand their external and internal environment so as to identify opportunities and threats that affects their business. This helps the management to decide future direction of an organization. It involves analyzing and evaluating the information about external and internal environment that can be obtained from various different sources. Using environmental scanning, an organization can examine the impact of different trends, events, issues, and expectations on the process of strategic management. Next is approaches to environmental scanning. There are three approaches which could be adopted for environmental analysis. These are, first, systematic approach. In this approach, information is collected systematically for analyzing the environment. Information about markets and customers, changes in legislation and regulations, policy statements of the government related to organization, business and industry is collected regularly to monitor changes in the environment. Regularly updating such information is essential not only for strategic management but also for the operational activities of the organizations. Second, ad hoc approach. In this approach, special surveys and studies are conducted by an organization to comprehend trends in the environment from time to time. For example, organizations conduct such studies where it has to launch new projects or to devise new strategies. Unpredicted developments may also be scrutinized with respect to their influence on the organization. Third, processed form approach. In this approach, an organization uses different sources to obtain information in a processed form. These sources are available both inside and outside the organization. When an organization obtains information provided by the government agencies and private institutions, it uses secondary data which is accessible in a processed form. Next are the techniques of environmental analysis. Companies use several techniques for analyzing and diagnosing the environment. These are SWOT analysis. SWOT is acronym for strength, weaknesses, opportunities and threats. A company can identify its strengths and weaknesses by analyzing the internal environment, also known as corporate appraisal, and opportunities and threats by analyzing the external environment. An effective strategy is one that exploits the opportunities and offsets the threats faced by an organization. Strengths. A strength is an intrinsic capability of a firm which it can use to obtain competitive advantage over its competitors. Weakness. A weakness is an intrinsic limitation or constraint of a firm which creates competitive disadvantage for it. Opportunity. An opportunity is a beneficial condition in the firm's environment which makes it possible for the firm to strengthen its position. Threats. A threat is an adverse condition in the firm's environment which may cause a damage or risk to its position. A brief list of strength, weakness, opportunities and threats are given below. Strengths include powerful brand image, high quality manpower, economies of scale, research and development ability, location facilities, genial industrial relations, modern technology, effective cost control. On the other hand, opportunities include delicensing, relaxations in import, FDI norms, reforms in capital market, growing urban incomes and population, and upgrading consumers. On the other hand, weakness include poor brand image, low credit rating, dispersed manufacturing location, poor quality of products, excess manpower, poor morale, weak research and development skills. Threats include low priced competition, political instability, recession, liberalization of imports and consumerism. Next is conducting the audit. An analyst must keep the following point in mind while doing a corporate audit to identify the strengths and weaknesses of a firm. Verbal information. Information can be collected from external and internal groups through searching questions, using structured questionnaires, depth interviews, etc. Spying. The analyst can obtain information by contacting with suppliers, dealers, customers, creditors, etc. Company records. Records can be used to obtain information about past performance of the company and other information such as employee turnover, dear relations, etc. It is very difficult to get such type of information through surveys and personal observations. Next, matching the strengths and weaknesses. In the next stage, the analyst tries to find a match between corporate strengths and environmental opportunities for competitive advantage. For example, to fill the gap in existing product mix, a firm can acquire a competing firm whose offerings can fill these gaps. When the products of the firm enjoy good position in the local market and there is strong chance that it can enjoy good reputation in the export market as well, then the firm can go for strategic alliance with a reputed foreign firm. Next technique is ETOP. ETOP is the acronym for Environmental Threat and Opportunity Profile. It determines the relevant environmental factors and their impact on the organization. ETOP is generally constructed in the manner given below. List environmental factors. A list is prepared for the different elements of the relevant environment. For example, economic environment may be characterized into economic growth rate, national income, investment, saving, reforms in capital market, industrial policy, monetary policy, etc. Next, evaluate importance of environmental factors. In this stage, the significance of each factor of the environment is closely evaluated and indicated in quantitative or qualitative factors. Assessing the impact. The impact of the relevant factor so analyzed can be positive or negative. Combine to get a bigger picture. In this final stage, the significance and impact of each factor is compared to create a concise overall picture. Next is forecasting techniques. Forecasting is a method in which future events that can have a major impact on an organization are estimated. This technique helps the managers in predicting the future elements of the organizational environment so that they can make decisions today to deal with the tomorrow environment. There are four techniques of forecasting given below. First, time series analysis. In this technique, variables are predicted by using historical trends such as growth of population, innovation in technology, changes in income, etc. Second, judgmental forecasting. This technique involves using customers, suppliers, employees, trade association, etc. to obtain qualitative information related to future trends. For example, sales representative can forecast growth in sales in various categories of products based on their interaction with the customers. In order to get the judgments, survey instruments may be sent to customers, suppliers, etc. Third, Delphi technique. In this technique, experts from the suitable field of study are questioned independently about the probability of occurrence of some event. After this, experts' responses are compiled and processes is sent to each expert. This process is repeated until all the experts give their consent regarding a particular forecasted event. Fourth, multiple scenario. It is very difficult to predict future trends because of various reasons such as wrong assumptions, changing trends, unexpected things, etc. To deal this, manager should try to formulate several alternative descriptions of future trends and events. Next is limitations of environmental analysis. There are many limitations of environmental analysis which are given below. First, based on assumptions. Forecasting is based on certain assumptions which may prove to be wrong. Generally, in forecasting, it is assumed that events do not change randomly, which may not be good in all cases. Thus, forecasting becomes unreliable. Second, no sufficient guarantee. The forecasting techniques only predict the future trends and does not give any guarantee that a particular trend will occur or not. Sometimes organizations have to face situations that they had not expected while environment analysis. Third, time consuming and expensive. This is very time consuming and expensive to collect, analyze and interpret the data for forecasting. Fourth, uncritical faith. Sometimes due to incorrect data, decisions on the basis of this analysis may be dangerous for the business. Now, let us summarize what we have learned in this module. The environment of business is the set of all the forces and factors which are external to and uncontrollable in nature but affect the functioning and growth of the organizations. The environment is dynamic, unpredictable, relative, composite, and challenging. Internal environment includes those forces and factors that are controllable by an organization. External environment includes those forces and factors that are not controllable by an organization. An organization has no control over these factors. Micro environment consists of those factors which are close to the business and exerts a direct influence on the capacity to work of an organization. Macro environment consists of those factors that offer opportunities and pose threats to the organizations. The components of macro environment includes economic, social and cultural, political, legal, technological, natural and international environment. Environmental scanning is a systematic process through which organizations monitor and understand their external and internal environment so as to identify opportunities and threats that affects their business. Systematic approach, ad hoc approach and processed form approach are the three approaches of environmental scanning. SWOT is acronym for strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. Thank you.